Hello aspirants, welcome to another session of the daily newspaper analysis. This video is brought to you by the Gurudev Academy. Firstly, we looked at the topics that we are going to look at. These are the topics. The first topic is that India-China confirms withdrawal of troops from PP-15 in Ladakh. See, yesterday we have covered this article extensively. I have shown you the map as well as to where all presently the tensions are there. So here why I have taken the article again is regarding to this photo here. See, when you look at this photo, here are the army personnel who participated in the Parvat Prahar exercise. This Parvat Prahar exercise, when we look at it, it took place in the eastern side of the Ladakh here. Okay, it took place in the eastern side of the Ladakh at an altitude of 14,000 feet. See, this was taking place in the eastern side. On the western side of Ladakh, there is another military exercise going on, that is Exercise Gagan Strike. Okay, it is Exercise Gagan Strike. Please remember, it is a Indian Army exercise. Okay, no other country is involved in this military exercise. It is just the Indian Army. As well as there has been news. Okay, there has been news that the Yudh Abhyas. Okay, Yudh Abhyas. This is their annual military exercise that happens between India and US. Okay, so there have been news floating in some of the media houses that this Yudh Abhyas is going to take place very close to the LAC. Okay, it is going to take place very close to the LAC here. That is around 100 kilometers from the LAC. So when it happens, please mark it out. Okay, very important news here. So again, UPSC has asked once the questions regarding your Ladakh location as well as few other places. So please pause the video and just put a map and mark some of the important places here, like this one, that is Daulat Beg Oldi. See, this Daulat Beg Oldi is the world's highest airstrip. Okay, so for now, it is under India's possession here. Okay, and then Galwan Valley. Okay, very important. Recent clashes that happened in 2020, it started in Galwan Valley only. Then we have the Shok River and Darbuk Leh as well. Fine, so these are some of the things that you have to remember. There is also one of the important national highway that goes up to Shimla here. Okay, the up to Shimla. And so these are the points you have to look at when you're practicing the maps. Then moving ahead, see, 384 drugs of essential medical list. Okay, so what is, firstly we'll look at what is essential medicines. Okay, so when you look at essential medicines are those that satisfy the priority healthcare needs of the majority of the population. Fine. So these are very, very important medicines that are available. Here, please remember, under your essential medicine list, not only the drugs are being put under the list, but also the medical devices, surgical implements, all these are put under your essential medical list. So what is the importance? See, this national list of essential medicines, this is given under your drug pricing control order of 2013. Okay, so this list is released by the government under drug pricing control order of 2013. What is the importance of NLM is this NLEM, whatever the drugs and the surgical implements are under NLEM that are monitored by the NPPA. Okay, that is your National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority. I'll repeat again. So NLEM, whatever the medicines and drugs and surgical implements that come under your national list of essential medicines, these medicines and the surgical implements are monitored by the NPPA, that is your National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority. And one more point is that this NPPA, it comes under Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Right? So please remember all these points. National list of essential medicines. Firstly, what is essential medicines? Then you have to know under which act is this medical list being provided, that is your drug pricing control order of 2013, as well as what is the importance of NLEM. NLEM, whatever drugs are included here that are monitored by your NPPA. Fine. Then moving ahead, see, India to hold a G20 summit in 2013. We already know that G20 summit next year is going to be happening in India. It is a very big news. So India has begun, it will begin its presidency, okay, begin its presidency of 1 year from December 1st of 2022 till 2023, okay. And as well as the news says that the G20 Leaders Summit will be held next year on September 9th to 10th in New Delhi, fine. So the G20 members, these are the G20 members. So you can remember them with this easy trick, that is Guruji Sita Ab SSC FCI Mein Job Karti Hai. So these are the countries. Okay, this will be easy for you all to remember which all countries are involved in G20. When we look at the summit that is going to happen next year in India, there are few countries that have been invited. Okay, these are invited countries. These are not part of the original G20. So some of the countries that have been invited are Bangladesh, UAE, Singapore, Spain, Mauritius, as well as Oman. Fine, these are the invited countries here. Then India is also part of another organization called as G20 Troika. Okay, G20 Troika. It will consist of current president, okay, current president, previous, as well as the next. Okay, so all these three form the G20 Troika. For now, for this year, that is the term that will end in November 31st, on 2022. For now, the G20 Troika consists of the current and the previous, that is Indonesia, Italy and India. Italy was the previous president, India is the present, and the Indonesia will be the next. Sorry, Indonesia is the previous, Italy will be the next, and India is the present president here. The next G20 Troika. Okay, the next G20 Troika is when India will take the presidency. When India will take the presidency, then the G20 Troika will consist of India, Indonesia and Brazil here. Fine. So these are some of the points that you have to know. Then moving ahead to the next news, Iran may urge India to restart oil import. See, India had stopped taking oil from Iran in 2018. Okay, in 2018 here. Why? Because, see, Iran and the Western countries, Iran as well as the Western countries, had signed a very important agreement called as JCPOA. Okay, so this was a JCPOA agreement was signed between Iran and the Western countries. What is the significance of JCPOA is that JCPOA allowed for the IAEA, okay, International Association of Atomic Energy. Okay, so this IAEA inspectors could go into Iran and inspect whether Iran was trying to develop a nuclear missiles here. And in return, what was the benefit for Iran was that when Iran started developing this centrifuges and all, so the world was very much afraid that Iran will be having nuclear power. That is why all the Western countries had put sanctions, economic sanctions on Iran. So once Iran signed this JCPOA agreement, Iran, whatever the sanctions were put on Iran, they were to be taken back. Fine. So this is the benefit. But what happened in 2018 is that US, which was the major partner in JCPOA, it came out of this deal. Since it came out of this deal, again, economic sanctions have been put on Iran. And when we look at what is the angle of India, India used to import a lot of low price oil from Iran. But when US came out of this JCPOA agreement, US started pressurizing India to cut down the oil import from Iran. And after 2018, the oil import has been cut down completely from Iran. Okay. Before that, Iran was the topmost exporter of oil for India. And now it is Iraq. Okay. Now Iraq exports the maximum oil to India. Other than this, see, there is another thing that has come in this article. The leaders of the two countries also expected to discuss the next step in developing of the Chabahar ports, Shehad Behesti. See, previously we have done in one of the video where an agreement has been signed regarding the Shahid Behesti between India and the Iranian authorities, as well as terminal run by India and possibility of linking to the international north-south transport corridor. So Chabahar is going to be linked. The Chabahar port is going to be linked with your international north-south transport corridor. So what is international north-south transport corridor? When we look at it, see, this corridor, that original trading partners here were Iran, Russia and India. Okay, they are the founding partners of this agreement. This agreement was signed in 2000 in St. Petersburg, Russia, and now it has expanded to the 11 countries. So this is the overall route of your international north-south corridor. Mainly it is what it is trying to do. It is trying to connect Mumbai to Moscow. Okay. It is trying to connect Mumbai to Moscow through the sea routes as well as through the land routes here. That is why the international north-south corridor is very important. India is trying to access the Chabahar port. India is trying to reach up till Afghanistan. When you reach Afghanistan, it opens the door for the five stans that are five Central Asian countries that are located here, and it also opens the door for Europe as well as to the Siberian region of Russia as well as China. Fine. So that is the importance of INSTC here. Moving ahead, So the next news. So Manrega social audits marred with delays. Okay. So this is again talking about your Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme. So what is the point is that they are telling that the social audit that has to be done by these Manrega workers, they are not doing it. The states are not implementing it. What is the issue here? Firstly, we look at what is social audit. See, social audit, it involves quality check of infrastructure that is developed under your Manrega scheme, financial misappropriation in the wages, like if there is any form of corruption when it comes to wages, as well as verifying for the procedural deviations. That is, when a fund is allocated under Manrega, some of the important procedures have to be followed to implement that scheme. Okay, so these, what is the social audit is trying to do? It is trying to see whether the infrastructure, the quality of the infrastructure is good and that has been developed under the scheme. They are trying to see if there is corruption in the wages, and also they are trying to see if there are any procedural deviations. So what has the ministry has said? So the ministry has come out with a statement and said that if there is a failure to carry out a social audit under Manrega, it will result in repercussions. Okay, repercussions that includes withholding of funds. And there is also a report published called as Social Audit Calendar versus Audit Complete. It has been found that just 14.29% of the social audit has been completed, which is a very, very low number. Okay, so we will look at what is social audit first, and also look at the concerns of the state as to why the states are not being able to do this social audit. So when we look at the social audit of Manrega, the original Manrega Act has the provision of social audit, but the procedures that have to be followed. Okay, it was issued in December 2016. Social audits are people-centric instruments. Why? Because it will show to the people as to where the funds have been used, as to how the funds have been used. Okay, so that is why it is people-centric. The union government bears the administrative cost of social audit. Again, they may form a question and they may ask, under Manrega scheme, who gives the fund for social audit? It is the union government here. According to the act, every social unit should be providing the fund equivalent to the 0.5% of the Manrega expenditure incurred by the states in the previous year. That is, whatever fund is being given, additional fund 0.5% has to be given for social auditing, is what the article is talking. Now, when we look at the concern of the states as to why there has been a lack of social auditing, when we look at it, see, the concern of the states firstly has been that according to various states, the social units have not received the administrative funds from the state. The states are complaining that whatever the extra funds that had to be provided to complete the social audit, the center has not transferred it to the states. It is what they are saying. Also, there is a delay in the disbursement of the funds. So what will happen? The delay in the payout of the funds causes policy paralysis. Very important word. Policy paralysis. Policy paralysis means failure of the original policy. Fine. Here, what was the name of the policy of Manrega? To provide employment for the rural people, guaranteed employment for the rural people for 100 days, as well as to improve the quality of infrastructure. And when we don't have the social audit, then the purpose of the policy is failed, is what they are talking here. Then, as per the report of the one of the NGO, it says that 8 state social audit and 9 in 2021 have got less than 50% of the fund. Okay, so this is again a very important cause of concern for the government here. Overall, over the years, we have been seeing with every budget, the budget and the allocation for the Manrega has been coming down. Again, when such things are happening, and when social audit becomes an important wheel in the functioning of Manrega, and funds are not provided by the center to the states, it again lowers the quality, as well as there forms a policy paralysis, is what the article is talking about. Fine. So that's it. That's it from today's video. You can follow us on the social media handles. You can follow us on YouTube, Telegram, Instagram, as well as on Facebook. Thank you.